Hi friends, so in this video we are gonna see nth derivative of some more functions. Now let's take an example. If y is ax plus b raised to minus m, then what is the nth derivative of this? Now to find the nth derivative, we are gonna follow one approach. That is, we will find the first derivative, that is y1, second derivative y2, then third derivative y3, and from these first three derivatives we will predict what could be the yn. So let's start with this. Now y1, as you all want to know, it is nothing but minus m raised to ax plus b raised to minus m minus 1. This is by using the formula of derivative into a. Now if you will find the y2 from the answer of y1, it is nothing but minus m into minus m minus 1 ax plus b raised to minus m minus 2 into a square, because already we were having one a in y1 and one more a of this y2, so it becomes a square. Let's find what could be y3. So y3 is nothing but minus m minus 1 minus m minus 2 ax plus b raised to minus m minus 3 into a cube. And now it's time to find out what could be the yn. Now to find yn, we will rearrange all the terms which we got in y1, y2 and y3. So if you all will observe, then we can say that in y1 we are getting m as negative. So here the minus 1 raised to 1 term is there. Now m is constant, I will keep it as it is. A is constant, I will keep it as it is. And here this term is nothing but ax plus b raised to minus sign outside m plus 1. Similarly, this second term, if we'll rewrite is, from the first term we are getting minus sign, from the second term we will get minus sign common, so this will become minus 1 raised to 2, because minus sign is coming 2 times. Next, m will remain as it is, it will become positive, this will become positive, that is m plus 1, this a square will remain as it is. And here we will get ax plus b raised to, by taking minus sign outside, we will get m plus 2 in bracket. Similarly, we will rewrite the third term. Now in the third term, we will get three negative signs. One from this minus m, one from this minus m minus 1, and one from minus m minus 2. So I will rewrite this as minus 1 raised to 3. Rewrite the terms, that is m positive, m plus 1 positive, m plus 2 positive. Next, a cube as it is, and this term we will rewrite as ax plus b, by taking minus sign outside we will get m plus 3 inside the bracket. Now let's guess what could be the yn. So as we were getting minus 1 raised to 1 in y1, minus 1 raised to 2 in the y2, minus 1 raised to 3 in y3, I will get minus 1 raised to n in yn. Similarly, we were getting m in case of y1, m into m plus 1 in case of y2, m into m plus 1, m plus 2 in y3. So in case of yn, we will get m plus 1, m plus 2, so on till m plus n minus 1. Since in case of y3 the last term was 2, in case of y2 the last term was 1, hence in case of yn the last term will be n minus 1. Next, in case of y1 we were getting a raised to 1, in case of y2 we were getting a square, in case of y3 we were getting a cube, hence in case of yn we will get a raised to n. Similarly, in case of y1 we are getting ax plus b raised to m plus 1, minus n outside. In case of y2, we were getting minus of m plus 2. In case of y3, we were getting minus of m plus 3. Similarly, in case of yn, we will get minus of m plus n. So, let's rewrite this. So, this will become minus 1 raised to n, m into m plus 1 into m plus 2, so on till m plus n minus 1 a raised to n. Now, this will this term will go in the denominator and this will become ax plus b raised to positive m plus n. Now, let's reduce the numerator. So, to reduce the numerator, what I am doing, I am converting this in terms of factorial. Now, let's observe over here. Here, the last term is m. So, what I'll do is, I will further multiply this side with the terms like 1, 2, so on till m minus 1. So, here, remaining terms as it is, that is m, m plus 1, m plus 2, and so on till m plus n minus 1 a raised to n. Now, as I am multiplying numerator with the terms like 1 into 2 till m minus 1, I have to multiply the denominator with the similar term. So, in the denominator, I will get 1 into 2 into dot 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 till m minus 1 into ax plus b raised to m plus n. Now, let's see what we got. So, in the numerator, minus 1 raised to n as it is. And here, this 1 into 2 into dot 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 till m plus n minus 1 has become m plus n minus 1 factorial. Next, a raised to n as it is. In the denominator, we got 1 into 2 into dot 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 till m minus 1. So, it is again m minus 1 factorial and ax plus b raised to m plus n will remain as it is. And this becomes the formula, that is nth derivative of ax plus b raised to minus m. Now, this formula is very useful to find out the nth derivative of multiple terms. So, let's see one more corollary which is related with this. So, in that corollary, we will try to find out nth derivative of y equal to ax plus b raised to minus 1. So, if you'll compare this with the derived formula or if you'll compare this with our question, then you can say that m is equal to 1. So, now what I'll do is, in the derived formula, I will just substitute m as 1. So, let's see what we get. So, we will get yn as, so minus 1 raised to n will remain as it don't have m. Here, when I'm substituting m as 1, so 1 minus 1 is 0 plus n, so only n factorial will remain. A raised to n as it is because it doesn't contain m. In the denominator, 1 minus 1, 0, and we all know that 0 factorial is 1. Next, ax plus b raised to n plus m, m is 1, so this will become n plus 1. And this becomes one more formula for nth derivative of y equal to ax plus b raised to minus 1 or y equal to 1 upon ax plus b. So, these formulas are very useful to find out the nth derivative of algebraic functions, but we'll see it in the later part.